Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action, sanctioned by the NWA, National Wrestling Alliance.
Welcome to World Championship Wrestling. I'm David Crockett, and with me is Tony Schiavone. Tony, we have an exciting program for the fans. We've got a lot of champions and a lot of action, too.
We're talking about the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, the new one, Magnum T.A., the National Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Buddy Landell is with us, World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, National Tag Team Champions, Ole and Arn Anderson. As you know, there is still no World Television Champion as of yet, but of course, that's coming up, that tournament, very soon after the first of the year.
That's correct. Plus, the Superstation Championship Challenge Series pits the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion Crusher Khrushchev against Pistol Pez Whiteley.
That's right, and also, as we have talked about earlier, the Bunkhouse Stampede is well underway, and congratulations to Magnum T.A.
That's right.
He won the very first Bunkhouse Stampede in Cleveland the other night. He is $20,000 richer. We talked about the National Heavyweight Champion, and let's bring him in right now. Now, he does not have J.J. Dillon with him. He is here alone, and I tell you what, the man wears that belt proudly, and he is a champion, Nature Boy Buddy Landell.
You know, Tony Schiavone, I know you and David Crockett get up every morning wishing that you could come out here and zing me and embarrass me on national TV, but it's not going to happen. We're talking about the Nature Boy Buddy Landell, the National Heavyweight Championship. That's what I held under my belt. Now, there's a lot of controversy that whose belt is a top contender for the world's title, the National Heavyweight belt, or the one that chump in the ring right there holds right now, the U.S. belt. Well, let me seesaw rumors right now, Magnum T.A. The National Heavyweight Champion is the man that stands first in line for the world strap, Ric Flair's belt. Now, who's zooming who, Magnum? I'm the National Heavyweight Champion, and not only am I the National Heavyweight Champion, but I am the original Nature Boy. Now, let me tell you something, Tony Schiavone. In the weeks to come, there's going to be some things happening that's going to set some people on fire around here. The Nature Boy Buddy Landell said it. Remember that, all right? Okay. David Crockett, like Ric Flair told you before, you do what you do best, being vice president and signing checks. Tony Schiavone, you keep wearing this material, and it's going to come back in style. Girls, the National Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Buddy Landell, is going to be coming to you. Magnum, anytime, any place, brother, the National Heavyweight Championship says it. Buddy Landell.
That's right.
All right, Buddy Landell, the National Heavyweight Champion. Let's go to the ring.
In the ring, United States Heavyweight Champion Magnum T.A. against Bill Tapp. Good drop kick.
He's still looking over here where Landell was.
Watch him. Takes him across. Belly to belly. Takes him down. Hooks it, and he's got it. The United States Heavyweight Champion, Magnum T.A. Oh, look at him. Look at the expression in his face.
We're going to take a look at this replay once again. This is a big guy, Big Bill Tapp. And the belly-to-belly suplex. The winner of the match, Magnum T.A. Well, there's a man who is slowly coming to see us right now who had some words for Magnum T.A., but I'm sure what you're thinking of right now is that World Television Tournament for that World Television title coming up in Greensboro.
Yeah, I'm hard-pressed thinking about it, Tony Schiavone. You know, the first time I came on the scene, I told some people, and see, right there's your response. These people know a true champion. I told you that I'm going to make a name for myself. I'm not going to tread on the Anderson name. I'm going to make a name for AA. And as you know, Tony Schiavone, what have I done? Yeah. I'm one half the National Tag Team Champions. I feel I'm former World Television Champion. The only reason I don't have the belt right now is it was stripped from me, stolen from me by Dusty Rhodes, stripped from me by Jim Crockett Promotions. But I'm going to tell you, I've said it once and I'm saying it again. The one way you earn these people's respect, your opponent's respect, and your respect, and your own self-respect as you go out there and you perform nightly on a nightly basis, day in, day out. So what I'm going to do, Tony Schiavone, I'm going to simplify everything. I'm just going to go out and win that World Television Tournament. It'll shut your mouth, it'll shut David Crockett's mouth, and it'll appease my own mind. It's been your pleasure.
All right, Arn Anderson, we'll see Ole and Arn Anderson in the ring when we return.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, in the ring, the National Tag Team Champions, Ole and Arn Anderson. They're going to take on the aggressive young team of Rocky King and the Italian Stallion.
should really be a good match because, like you said, David, aggressive young team and certainly two strong young individuals. There's the Stallion, Rocky King on the outside.
They go right after it. Look at Iron. Starts to pound away the back of the neck. Now he goes right after that arm. The Stallion switches. Still has it. Iron trying to make it to the ropes. He keeps it in the center of the ring. Comes up with the arm bar. Still has that armbar.
Well now, a little bit out of the book of the Andersons, as the Stallion just took hold of that left arm and would not let go, as we see Tommy Young, the referee here today.
All right, the Stallions and Rocky King are gonna have to take the Andersons down on the mat. They expect to win, because the Andersons are gonna do exactly what Ole's doing now. He's gonna go after that arm. Marka, all right, makes the tag. Rocky King, he's pressed, he's ready. Quick. Get the pound away, rights and lefts. Ole switched him, right in the center. King still fighting. King won't give up. He knows what he's going to try to do. Ole puts him in under the ropes.
Ole's in control here, though. Even though those blows were pretty good blows by Rocky King, Ole had his whereabouts and now has control.
Watch the Minnesota record. Look at him. Iron Anderson, big name Double A. And before Ole, they call him the Rock. You see Rocky King now.
David, every time
out of it.
Yep. Every time I see Ole and Arn Anderson, as we're going to take a look
at that slam.
The trademark right here.
Oh, yes.
I think about their cousin Ric Flair. And, you know, the situation between Dusty Rhodes and Ric Flair is by no means over.
Oh, it's not.
We get tons of letters each and every week supporting Dusty Rhodes and backing Dusty Rhodes 100%. I mean, the mail that we get is tremendous here.
It was not settled. In no way.
We're going to be having our address a little bit later on.
We'd love to hear from you fans. Also, that address that you'll see later on will be in case you want to write one of the wrestlers. You can write to that address. All right, look at Ole. Still with that arm. Pushing him down. Driving him into the ropes. Crossface. Still has it. Look at it. Didn't he drive that crossface? Bends the nose. Puts it right across the mouth. Keeps him from breathing. King trying to fight back. Can he do it? Snapmare. Look at him. Holds on to the hair. Drives the knee to the back of the neck. Now. Look at Arn. Right for that arm. Takes him down. Step over. Hey, remember, coming up, Tully Blanchard will be here. Also, Tony, you know you were talking about Ric Flair, Dusty Rhodes. Dusty, the American Dream, will be here. Look at him, stretch him out, stretch that arm. Here he goes. Stomping right down the hall. Also, the World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express. Look at him, he's got him up. Position. You always see the very best right here on World Championship Wrestling and the Superstation.
He's called for a knee from Arn.
The Andersons will take a tremendous amount of punishment just to get that right punch in. Bends him back. Now he has him. What's he going to do? Goes after the arm again. Takes him down. The Minnesota Wrecking Crew, Ole and Iron Anderson. This is what you call teamwork. Beautiful move by Rocky. Good drop kick. Iron tried to block it.
Arn was ready that time. What an atomic drop on Rocky King.
Crossed his eyes. Fix him up. There's that gourd buster.
The gourd buster. Lights out.
The Minnesota Wrecking Crew. Ole and Arn Anderson. And watch the destructive power this team has. Look at Arn. He picks him up for that gourd buster. Look, he raises him. Now watch him. Driving right into the mat. Your winners, the National Tag Team Champions, Ole and Arn Anderson.
Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll, when we return.
In the ring now, Gerald Finley. He's up against Tully Blanchard and his Perfect 10 Baby Doll. And the fans already are starting to hear the sounds, I quit.
Oh, my goodness. Shake that scorpion's hand.
We have to watch Tully. He still has Baby Doll, but he does not have the United States Heavyweight Championship. How has it affected him?
Now you see Tommy Young looking on. I ought to mention Tommy Young, 5-time Professional Wrestling Referee of the Year and the number one seeded referee in the NWA, who was with us to talk about the situation between Dusty and Ric Flair. Now Tommy in the ring this week.
And why the decision that was made by Tommy, and everybody is abiding by that decision.
Bob Geigel gave the belt back to Ric Flair, as we said.
Watch Tully. Good move. Goes right for the leg.
Some quickness that time from Tully Blanchard.
You just don't see that little gleam or glitter in his eye. You hear Baby Doll trying to shout encouragement to Tully.
You know, she, even though she's a lady,
people call her other things, but go ahead.
She's used for intimidation as much as anything else.
Oh, yes.
Constant psych out when she's there, telling the opponent to give up. Encouraging Tully. There's a look at Baby Doll.
Drives that knee right into the arm.
Usually when Tully's in that ring, though, Tony, he's always talking to the wrestler too, taunting him. But you don't hear that with him right now.
No, I was getting ready to say, you got to give him credit for one thing, even though he lost the U.S. Heavyweight title. Obviously, he's right back in condition.
Yes, his
concentration is where it should be. And that's the way all great
headbutt. Hey, you say concentration, but he's down now. Here goes Finley right after him. Headbutt again. Driving those fists into the midsection. He's got it now. Here he goes. Whips him across into that turnbuckle. Starts to drive in. Foot right in the face. Tully goes up. Puts that elbow. Heads down for that pin. Finley kicks out. That was a desperation kick out.
It really was. Blanchard right on top of him now.
Goes right back on him. Good form, right in the chest. Maybe don't like that. And another one. Takes him out of the ring. Now you get to see a little bit of the old Tully Blanchard. That with a back of the neck. A forearm now. Takes Finley out again. Out on that floor. Slow in getting up.
Tully, there you see him pacing back and forth. He's ready.
He really is. He's like a cat ready to pounce on him any time. Look at him.
Pulls him in. Just the midsection. Here he goes. Whips him across the rope. Switch now by Finley. Tully quickly catches him with a foot in the face. He comes around. Drops the elbow. Across that chest. Picks him up, though. Doesn't try for the pin. Has him. Suplex, yes. Has him on the ropes. Suplex rolls over the pin, hooks the leg. He's got him. You're a winner. Tully Blanchard with his perfect 10 baby doll, and she is proud of him.
Well, she should be also, because look at this impressive move. Even though he doesn't have that U.S. title, he has not lost anything at all in the ring. Tully Blanchard the winner, and we'll be back with America's team. Don't go away. That's the U.S. heavyweight title held by that man. One part of America's team, the other part with us also, Dusty Rhodes. This is Magnum T.A.
Well, you know, I couldn't help but listen to the words by the national heavyweight champion a little while ago talking about being the number one contender of World's Heavyweight Championship. Well, Buddy Landell, really, who is Zooming Who? Because it's real plain to see. I'm the United States Heavyweight Champion. I am the number one contender. And any time you have any idea in your mind you can take this away from me, jump. Don't stand back. Don't think about it too long, because there's a lot of people out there want a shot at this. And I'd be glad to mix it up with you at any time.
I don't believe that there is any explanation for this right here. I mean, you can go all over the world and not see nothing as bad as this right here. And the thing is, me and the Maggie Mae just got back from Anchorage. We was on the private JCP sports plane, flew out there, dedicated ourselves to a group of kids, and came back here. Nature Boy Ric Flair, Slick Rick, if you will, it's not over between me and you. You got a little bit to do yet before you finish your thing. The legend and the man, there's a big difference between the legend and the man, Nature Boy Ric Flair. Ole and Arn Anderson, I'm gonna tell you right now, live on television, Jack, that I'm gonna hurt one of you real bad in the real near future. In the real near future. I don't know which one yet, but I'm gonna do it to it real bad. So let's get down to real business talk, Ric Flair. Let's get down to dollars and cents. You dealing money. You wearing them seal sucker suits. You walking around playing risky business with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. I'm walking around a crippled man wearing a boot with a steel toe in it, having to hobble around. I ain't forgetting nothing. I want you to remember one picture, baby. Back that camera just a little bit. I'm gonna give him one picture to look at and all his money here, baby. Ric Flair, $33,000, Jack.
America's team, Dusty Rhodes and Magnum T.A. Let's go to the Rock and Roll Express. And Robert Gibson starts off. David's talking about exciting the crowd. America's team out here to talk with us. And then the Rock and Roll Express.
The men from the Great North. Look at good hit. Got it now. Goes down for that pin. Referee says no. But Tony, you're right. Magnum T.A. and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, out there and all, come out in all their splendor. They'll never be cold.
Not at all.
He goes across. Look at Mort. Good. Good drop kick. Arm back. Takes George South over.
That is awesome. And that's why they are the NWA World Tag Team Champions.
They are the tag team of the 80s. The Rock and Roll Express. They represent the youth of America. Desire, because they have it. When they went in, went after the world championship against the Russians and won it, that was great.
And you think we've seen some great tag teams so far. Did you see the pressure on the chin of George South? We've seen Ole and Arn Anderson. We've seen America's team. We're looking at the Rock and Roll Express. We're going to see the Russian team very soon, and we're going to see the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors, all here today.
So you only see the very best right here on the Superstation in World Championship Wrestling. Tagging in and out, teamwork. Here they come. Double elbow in the chest. Robert Gibson in against George South. He has that arm. Twisting. Now switches. Gibson drops down, kicks him, comes right back up. Just ready to go in after him. Tries not to, he's too close to the corner. They tie up. Tag is made. Ricky Morton's in against George South. Has that headlock in that corner. Needs to get out of it. And that's exactly what he does. Ties up with Vernon Dixon. Goes after the arm. Referee Tommy Young watching, checking. Gibson comes in now. You see, he has that arm. He takes him down. Has that chicken wing. Deaton trying to figure out how to get out of it. Robert comes up, drops a knee. Makes the tag to Ricky Morton. Morton comes in. What's he going to do? Elbow.
Their ability to communicate with each other, Dave, even though they don't even say a thing to each other in the ring.
They can just look.
Exactly, it's like one big flow. They are so good together as a team. And as all great tag teams will do, they keep their action in their half of the ring, as you can tell right there.
Has an arm bar on Vernon Deaton.
Is he in the ropes? Tommy
Not
Young checking.
Quite. Our fans are getting a little impatient. But they love to watch the World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express.
Deaton now doing the right thing. He's got a tag. He's in his half of the ring. Now George South.
Oh, good form! Here he goes. George South trying to get away from him.
I think he got Ricky Morton a little mad that time.
Oh, you know it. All right, now Gibson comes in. Here he goes. Goes down for that pin. I think he wants to punish him a little bit more. Position. Slam. Hard on the mat. Guns up. Knee across the chest. Goes down. Just wants to lay on him. Say, all right, I'm going to teach you a lesson. A knee by South. Fist to the head. Starts to pound away on Gibson. Makes that tag to Vernon Deaton.
And now the chant of rock and roll from the fans.
And he hears it. Gibson hears it. Makes that tag. Here they go. You know what's going to... A little backdrop. Look at him. Here they go. Double drop kick. drags him out, drops down. Gibson stands guard, and that is it. You're looking at the World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express.
The World Six-Man Tag Team Champions, Ivan Koloff, Nikita Koloff, Crusher Khrushchev, Crusher also the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion. The chant from the fans, Road Warriors, Road Warriors, I'm sure you hear what they have to say.
First of all, American, where is this director around here? I told him time and time again, we insist on having Russian flag hung up in here in this studio to
Rob?
Show respect for
Did
us.
You check with Rob Wheeler, who's
yes,
in charge?
I'm going to check with him across the side of his head if he doesn't get flag up here. Now, Rock and Roll Express, you think you're riding pretty high now. Very content with yourself. Well, our World Tag Team belt was robbed away from us. But we're not going to rest. You've got everything to lose now. We've got nothing to lose. So you'd better watch out. Now, we brought with the courtesy of NWA a VTR tape to show of these Road Warriors. On the first encounter against us, we left them laying, showing that we are superior. You see it right here. And again, they come back in whenever we're wrestling in match. You see right here? We're minding our own business, having our match. But these Road Warriors, you will see in a minute, come out here, jump us from behind. This is the only way Americans can ever try to get anything done. Jumping us from behind. You see how we're demolishing, destroying our opponents in this match. This is what the Road Warriors couldn't take. They come out. Whether it's political reason, personal reason, they always seem to come and stick their nose in. They declared war on us. World War III, they said. Well, that is fine. We're taking it like a war. And you will see again, we will show that we are superior by leaving them laying. You watch here what Nikita does with the chain. He takes, just like an old custom in many states in America, it is still legal to hang for a crime, to hang a person. And that's exactly what Nikita is doing, turning this American around and punishing with American ways. Hang it by the neck. That is right. This man here is going around now. He can't hardly talk. Well, that's just too bad. It shows again that we are superior to this team of Road Warriors. And if they want to keep bringing it to us, that's fine. We'll keep knocking him down. Time and time again, it has been proven in all different sports that the Russian athlete is superior. And now, Road Warriors, you have found out the hard way that we are superior to you. Every time you try to attack us, we leave you lame. So you come ahead. Third World War you want? That is fine. We will bring it. And they talk about this tournament. World TV title. That is fine. The Kremlin has not chosen yet which Russian is going to be a representative. But whoever it is, we can be sure that the World TV title will come to the Koloff family.
All right, Nikita Koloff's in the ring.
And there you see the Russian nightmare, Nikita Koloff. He's going to take on Mac Jeffers. Crusher Khrushchev is in there, giving some last final words. Crusher Khrushchev, the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion.
And don't think for 1 minute Mac Jeffers doesn't realize that if he gets an advantage on Nikita Koloff, that it will quickly turn into a three-on-one situation.
Just exactly what the Russians said. Talking about Ivan. He said, watching them destroy that team that they were wrestling. That was 3-on-2. 3-on-2 in that videotape. That's what happened. The Road Warriors came in on them because of that.
Look at Nikita, the Russian nightmare.
Driving a knee into the back.
Well, there goes Mac Jeffers once again, hitting very hard. And look at Ivan.
The arrogance of these men. Ivan Koloff, Nikita Koloff. And Crusher Khrushchev. Look at Nikita, will not let him in the ring. Watch it, look at Ivan. There you see. Nikita standing there. Watch it, here it goes. Elbow right in the chest. Doesn't try to pin him. They delight and embarrassing, tormenting, torturing their opponents. Look at him. Picks him up by the neck and throws him. Ivan stands outside the ring and taunts Max. Kita slams. Drops a leg across the neck. The whole time. There. They enjoy every minute when they can embarrass an American. Quickly, Mac Jeffers. Fighting back. Will not give up. Kita came in with that elbow. Catches him, knocks the wind out. Look at him. Look at Nikita. He's ready.
Watch out here. You know watch out.
Here. He caught him with that clothesline. Again, he sort of strolls over. Doesn't try to pin him.
He's out. He's out. He's beaten, like Tommy Young said. You could hear him say it all the way over here. What's he doing? Oh, not another
one. Him again. Nikita yelling for the Road Warriors. He goes down for that pin. Pounces on his prey. Has him down. Your winner, Nikita Koloff. Just one part of the American. All right, watch this. That is Nikita Koloff, the Russian Nightmare. Your winner.
Well, I may mention the fact that even though Tully Blanchard no longer has a U.S. heavyweight title, still as impressive as ever in the ring.
Well, I tell you what, you know, a young guy trying to make a name for himself out here on national television, gave him a slight wrestling lesson, paddled him a little bit, pinned him 1, 2, 3. But, you know, last week I was down a little bit, down in the dumps because of what happened to Starrcade 85, the greatest event of all time. But, you know, I started thinking, called my dad on the phone, and he said it was a miracle, son. It was a miracle. And I thought to myself, he's absolutely right. It was a miracle that Magnum walked out of the ring with the United States Heavyweight Championship around his waist at Starrcade 85, because I never said the words, I quit. I never said it. You got people out here chanting, all over the country chanting everywhere I go, I quit, I quit. The words never came out of my mouth. But getting back to it, the definition of a miracle, for all you people out there that don't know, an instance of divine intervention. So you think about it, Magnum T.A., what a miracle is. And you were in the ring, and you know that Tully Blanchard never said, I quit. Never did the words cross my lips. And Magnum T.A., when you get inside that ring in a wrestling match, which I defeated you and pinned you and showed you that I'm a superior wrestling machine, I will have the United States Heavyweight Championship back around my waist, just like it should rightfully be now. Because, you know, Magnum, I quit. I didn't want it. All those matches, no disqualification, no rules that you and Dusty Rhodes thrive on. I thrive on the pure sport, the pure thing that it says on that championship belt, wrestling, United States Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, not I Quit Champion or any other kind of champion. So you think about it, Magnum. You think about it. You think about what a miracle is, and you think about the man that beat you and put all those finishing bruises on you. And you know, Magnum, you think about it. 35 successful title defenses and only one loss. So you think about that, Magnum. You get back in that ring in a wrestling match, and Tully Blanchard will walk out the United States Heavyweight Champion.
We're coming right back with our Superstation Championship Challenge Series.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the Superstation Championship Challenge Series is for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship. The challenger, Pistol Pez Whatley. The champion, Crusher Khrushchev. And in the ring with Crusher Khrushchev, Ivan Koloff, the captain, general, the commander, the man behind the Russian team.
AC Pez, he is ready. Pistol Pez Whiteley, a man that's like a cat. Very quick. Very, very strong. Good move, goes behind. As Crusher. Crusher trying to come out of it. Takes him down. Pez spins around. Has that arm. You've got to figure out what will be the strategy in this game. Remember, you have to win by a pinfall or a submission.
David, that's right. And Pistol knows that not only is Crusher a bigger man, but he has Ivan Kolob down for Florida contender.
That is right.
Sure, Pistol is going to try to wear him down. One maneuver after another, a go behind, a takedown. Try to wear the big man down to where he's on the same level.
And Crusher is a big man. He's probably about 4 or 5 inches taller.
Switch now.
A pass.
Good arm drag.
Comes up with that arm bar. Pez now. Looks like he's content to wear Crusher down. You can see Ivan right there. He's shouting instructions. This is for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship. Referee Tom Young is still saying it. His advantage is to Pistol Pez Whiteley. He still has the hold. They see Crusher. He's pulling the tights. I see he's got the tights again. Pez has it. Still has that arm. Wisely. He felt the momentum of the weight of Crusher Khrushchev pulling him over. So Pez quickly let loose. Gets out the center of that ring. Does not want to go in that corner because Ivan Kolob is there. Tap. Knee in the midsection. Has the arm. Crusher twisting. Pez now. Ah. Dunk to the head. Pulling at that arm. Realize it. Crusher, because he is the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion.
Oh, good maneuver.
Good move, fireman's carry.
Really was, David. That's, well, that's one of the reasons he's a champion. You know, we seem to talk about the Russians and tag team combination all the time, rightfully so, because they always seem to gang up on somebody.
Yes.
But as single wrestlers, you can see right there that Crusher Khrushchev, very talented.
Tommy Young calling for the break. Here they go, crossing the rope. Good. Drop kick up in. Arm drag, takes him over. Arm bar, hooks it in.
Boy, Ivan Kolob really hot at ringside about something.
Ivan realizes the longer this match goes, the more chance Pistol Pez Whiteley has of winning. This young man has got a lot of stamina.
That's right.
An awful lot.
He's in here to wear this, like we said before, wear this big Russian down. For the Russian, a quick win would be what he wants. For Pistol Pez, he wants to take him right to the limit, see what he's made of.
And in the ropes. Look out. Probably try to drive something in the midsection. He does. Knock that wind out. And again. Here they go. Across in the road. Crusher drops down. Pez leaps over. Goes under. Side body lock. Goes down with a pin. Almost. Oh,
big kick out that time, David.
Arm drag. Arm bar. Hook. got him down. But there again, Tony, remember we said, you've got to wear him down. You just saw Crusher shoot Pez up just like he was a rocket. Crusher is just too strong right now.
You're right, he is too strong, and Pistol knows this. As he holds onto that arm, David, you know he's going through in his mind, what next? What strategy can I use? Because obviously, like you said, the Russian is not worn down yet. Still a lot of fight left in him.
This is fitting the strength of the Russians against the endurance and quickness of Pistol Pez Whiteley. Still has that arm. All right, in the ropes. Here they go. Across. Tackle. Good drop kick. Arm drag. Thumbs up, arm bar. Hold him down. That's what he needs to do. Which man has the advantage? Pez has the arm. You see Crusher? I think he bit him. Ivan. He's upset.
Boy, he's quick to point out when the other team maybe stretches the rules a little bit.
Oh, poor man.
But Tommy Young in control right now, the referee, calming down Ivan Koloff, as you can see.
They're in the ropes. Go for the break. This has the arm twist. Switch now by Crusher. Oh! Dropped him right across the ropes.
Smart move that time by the Russian because he was just using the momentum of both men. Certainly a move where...
Hey, see, Ivan realizes, though. He realizes it. Pez is in trouble. Crusher's got to make his move.
But Crusher's
the arm.
Yeah, he's in trouble also. Oh, that was a big one. Right up against the side of the head, and Crusher still in a lot of pain.
Crusher now. Trying. Still holding that arm.
Okay, Superstation Championship Challenge Series, and we'll have more of this for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight title right after this.
AC Crusher using the ropes, trying to cut him off. Pez got his backslide, has him down there, Pez. Count of two, almost one more. That's all he needs, one more. Crusher goes right for the throat. He can cut the wind, the air supply off. He's got it. Look at Ivan trying to say, come on, get over. Get on him. But there again, Crusher is tired.
He really is. He's really starting to wear down. And if Whiteley could get an advantage, right now would be the time to make his move, David.
If he can hold on, if Pez can hold on, he'll have it. Because the Russian... Crusher Khrushchev, AC. He just doesn't have the endurance that Pez has. Come on, Pez, you can do it. Here he goes. Into the ropes. Went up for that drop kick. Once, two. Goes down for the pin. Two.
Ivan Koloff, you... Probably could hear him in the microphones, and that was a three count.
Full packages. He has it.
Tell you what, that was close. Many big men have been pinned like
that's
that.
Right. That is. Crusher now holding on for dear life. Come on.
He's trying to cut it off. Twisting that neck. Takes him down. Goes down for that pin. Count of two. Two again. Now, here he goes. Starts to pound away the side of the neck.
Khrushchev regaining now his second win right here, David. Now Whatley's got to try to take it right out of him.
Oh, look at that. Look at
toe
that.
To toe.
Jab. He's got the ropes. He's got the ropes back there.
Well,
look at Tommy. Come on, Tommy.
Tommy saw it. He saw the ropes that time. Whatley had his shoulders up, too. Could have been a pin right there.
Everything. Right. Look out for Ivan. You know. Look at him. You see? He starts trying to sneak around the corner. Look at him. Oh no, Ivan. Russia is not. Russia bends it back. Hard one across the chest to knock the wind out. And again.
Khrushchev shouldn't be doing this.
No! That's right. Because here he goes. Benz has got him. He's just about got him. Down. Legs over for the pin. No. Count up two.
Got out of it again, David. A big Russia. Both men are really drained right now. Both men tired.
Pistol Pez Whatley not giving up. He's driving the knee in the midsection. Takes it. Switch now by Pez. Right. Runs right into the knee. Pressure goes up. Second rope now. He's going higher. Top rope. Pez has him. Oh, here he goes. Slam over the top rope. The back. The Pez. He's feeling it too. Both men. Battling it out. Headbutt. Headbutt again. Drop kick. Goes out.
Oh, that was a great drop kick. You notice how Whatley flipped that time on the drop kick? What a unique drop kick that was. Oh!
A dive right on him.
And now they're down on the floor. Whatley diving right through the ropes.
He went right after him. Here they go. Across. Dive across. Headbutt. Pass him down for that pin. Wait a minute, Ivan grabs his legs. He's having to fight two men now. Clothesline. Again, two Russians. I guess one American.
Once again, it was Ivan Koloff pulling the man right off. Once again, David.
Watch this. Pez wants it bad. He dives through the ropes and goes right after Khrushchev Khrushchev. But your winner and still Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion, Khrushchev Khrushchev.
Each match during our final month of the Superstation Championship Challenge Series must be pinfall or submission. We're with Jim Crockett once again for our announcement of the match for next week.
That's right. Next week, James J. Dillon will bring his three finest. I'm talking about the National Heavyweight Champion, Buddy Landell, Black Bart, and Thunderfoot. We're going to have a great six-man tag. They're going to take on the Raging Bull, Ron Bass, and Ronnie Garvin.
Should be a great six-man match. You hear the fans' response. Next week, our Superstation Championship Challenge Series, a big six-man tag team match featuring the National Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Buddy Landell. We'll be right back.
Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors with Paul Ellering. Go after Paul Garner and Larry Clark. And they're going to meet their doom. In the ring now, Animal! Elbow across the chest. Hawk goes up. Just to the head.
What an explosion when they hit the ring, dude.
Oh. Look at this. Oh. Oh, that hurts. That hurts. Hey. No. He doesn't want a penny. You know why? See what that man's wearing? He's wearing red. You talk about an explosion.
They got Russian on the brain right now.
When the Road Warriors and the Russians meet, that is going to be an explosion.
That knee lift set him all the way over to his corner. I don't think Larry Clark really wants to get in there.
Oh, he came in big and said, suddenly he realized, said,
who he was again.
I think I made a mistake. He said, now he says, I know I made a mistake. And Animal says, I'm going to show you how big a mistake. Power slam.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, here it comes. Whiplash. Ooh. Put whelps all over him. Catches him with that knee lift. Here he goes.
Take a hamburger out of him, Hawk.
Paul Ellering outside still has that collar around his neck.
Yeah, still has that neck brace on. Hit from behind by Nikita Kolov. And then we saw when the Russians came out here of the tape when they tried to hang Animal or make that mark with the chain. Boy, they certainly have used it. Notice how they've used the chain against the Road Warriors.
Ow.
Oh! Hawk now.
The fans love it.
Encouraging his opponent to get up.
You know, when these two teams meet, the Road Warriors and the Russians, the fans are just going to go nuts. Because we all want to see the Russians get their just reward. And I'm sure that the Road Warriors will give them exactly that. That is what they're going to give the Russians.
Compare that clothesline from Animal to the Russian sickle by Nikita Kolov. Whose is more awesome? There's the National Tag Team Championship belt. And the National Tag Team Champions, as you know, still the National Tag Team Champions are the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, Ole and Arn Anderson.
Tony Giovanni, you being a man and calling yourself a man, if you are a man, if an individual had just had his leg broke, had just failed to win the World Championship from Ric Flair, would he be out here standing around with Magnum TA looking like a couple of twin koala bears? Where's his priorities at? Let me ask you. Dusty Rhodes ought to be worrying about getting his leg healed, achieving a few things in his life instead of standing around here modeling a fur coat. It sounds a little ridiculous to me. Priorities are what we're talking about. We're talking about winning titles. Right now, my priorities lie in the world television title, Dusty Rhodes. I don't care about fur coats. I don't care about glamour. All I care about is winning the belt that rightfully belongs to me.
The TV title tournament is coming up. We're going to be in that. And I guarantee you when it's done, Dusty Rhodes is going to be going out there like a chicken sucking eggs. He's not going to have a chance at it. The belt's going to go back where it belongs on Arn. As far as these national tag team titles, we're still looking for somebody even that much close to us that can be coming, have a chance to get those world titles. There's nobody going to do it. I listened to Dusty Rhodes talking about hurting somebody real bad. We expect it. I have my nose broken, teeth knocked out. Everybody talks about hurting somebody. But that's all it is, talk. We're the only ones that do it, Dusty. Take a look. Let your eyes go down past your belly and take a look down your leg and take a look at that ankle. You know what it is? Broken. And you know who did it? The Andersons did it. When you talk about doing something like that, it's just hot air. Just like everything you talk about is hot air. If you're going to do something, Dusty Rhodes, you ain't the man. You aren't going to do it to us. Everybody'd like to see the Andersons go down. It hasn't happened yet. It's never going to happen. We're the champions. We're going to enter the tournament. We're going to get that TV title. We're going to enter these battle royals, these bunkhouse matches, and we're going to take 20 grand every time we're in one. And then nobody's going to do nothing about it because we're Andersons. We're the best.
Speaking of injury, right there's a living example in the ring, right there. Ask Sam Houston about the Anderson brothers.
Let's go to Sam Houston in the ring.
There you see him. The young man from Texas, Sam Houston against Mike Nichols. A handshake before the two men do battle. Clean break.
Right away, that left arm now taped up of Sam Houston, and Nichols goes right to work on it. Elbow right on the noggin. Up with an arm bar again. David, happy anniversary. To Mr. and Mrs. E.R. Chris of Shreveport, Louisiana. And they say that World Championship Wrestling is their favorite program. And they're speaking for themselves and many other people down in Louisiana. And they celebrated this year their 53rd year of marriage together.
Is that right?
No, I'm sorry, 59th year of wedding.
Anniversary. Well, that's a long time.
That's a long time to be married. Congratulations from all of us at World Championship Wrestling.
Say that again. Congratulations on 59 years.
World Championship Wrestling, 1250 South. I'm International, Atlanta 30303. Write to us. Anniversary announcements of 50 years or more, or any questions or comments. And like David said earlier, if you want to write to one of your favorite wrestlers, we get this all the time from our fans. If you want to write to one of your favorite wrestlers, write to him at that address. In care of World Championship Wrestling.
Oh, yes.
Love to hear from you.
And I'd like to say congratulations to a friend of mine, Gene Davis, in Palm Springs, Florida, that just got married last week. Congratulations to him, and my condolences go out to his wife. Look at Houston. Takes Nichols over, but Nichols quickly bridges these two young men.
David, I'd like to say hello to Don Jones. Columbus, Ohio, suffered a heart attack this past week. He's just getting out of the hospital, and all of our thoughts go out to him. Big wrestling fan of World Championship Wrestling in Columbus, Ohio. Hello, Don. Hope to be hearing from you very soon.
That is right. I hope you're watching. Just keep cool.
Big kick out that time. Boy, I tell you what, Nichols almost went right through the ropes.
Hey, coming up, the Barbarian and Paul Jones, Tony. Also, Ron Garvin. And if we're lucky, maybe we can get America's team, Dusty Rhodes and Magnum TA, back.
We're also going to see the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. Talking about a stick of dynamite right there.
Also, you know, I'd like to have the Rock and Roll Express out here. Maybe we'll get them all out here.
Okay. We'll do our best.
If we have time. Because you see nothing but the best. Right here on the Superstation in World Championship Wrestling.
A warning from Tommy Young that time about the clenched fist by Sam Houston. Fans are calling for the Bulldog. Now Mike Nichols As Tommy Young was checking to see if he wanted to give, says no. But I tell you what, Houston has a lot of pressure on that shoulder.
All right, Sam has it. Right in that knee, in the arm.
You hear the chant of Bulldog once again. I don't think Houston's ready yet, David. He's really been working on that arm. Nichols going right to that arm that Ole and Arn Anderson were talking about, that they broke with the help of Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll.
That is right. Nichols has the arm twisted now. These two young men, they want to get up that ladder. They need a win. Good move by Houston.
I think Houston may have Nichols a little bit angry right now, which should work to his advantage.
Right to left in. Look at him, boy. Now, bam.
Whoa.
Came right.
One back. Big right hand.
The yelling Bulldog. You gonna do it? Switch now by Nichols. Comes in. Bulldog.
Right over the ropes. What a Bulldog that was.
That's it.
Boy, I tell you what, we usually see him set the man up in the corner for the Bulldog, go all the way across the ring, but watch now. Nichols reverses the whip into the ropes, and Houston will catch him right here with that Bulldog. Impressive win from Sam Houston. We're going to talk with Paul Jones of the Barbarian and at the Raging Bull when we return. Number one, Paul Jones, without a doubt, one of the strongest men in wrestling right here, the Barbarian.
Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? Well, nobody cares. What people are concerned about now is who's afraid of the Barbarian. You know, a lot of things have happened in the last week or so that makes me feel like a giant. Let me tell you something. I told you people that the Barbarian is the strongest man in professional wrestling today. And I'm going to show it, I'm going to prove it by not only beating but annihilating wrestlers. Fail to prepare, then you prepare to fail. That is what it is, and that is what it's going to be, because he's going to go through wrestlers like you won't believe. And you line up. Dusty Rhodes, Magnum GA, the Raging Bull, Rock and Roll Express. And the list goes Ron Bass. And the list goes on and on. The Road Warriors, everybody line up. Because this man is going to be knocking at your door because I have something to prove. One time around here, there was a man said, I have a dream. Well, he doesn't have a dream anymore. But I can stand here and I can tell you I have a dream, and my dream is to prove to every one of you that this man is the strongest professional wrestler in the world today. And right here on network television, I am going to prove it to you, and that's all.
Go to the ring.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are waiting for the Raging Bull to enter the ring to take on Kent Glover. The Bull is outside. This is part of it. Psychological warfare, even before you get into the ring. There you see the Bull. And what a man he is. Takes his time. Take off his chaps.
Mr. Intensity, David Crockett.
Ooh, don't you know it. We start now. He does cross.
Oh, what a drop kick.
Good job. Snare takes him over. Drops across. Look at him use the legs. Oh, you can hear him. He latched on him. Oh, he's got him. Tighter and tighter. He's squeezing with those legs. Glover makes it to the ropes. Oh, man, he comes up. He's ready.
Quick as a cat, David, and like you said, as soon as the move was broken, he was right up quickly on his toes. Such a great athlete, and we're taking a look. We've seen him a couple times up close, but Whenever you get a chance to see this man up close, you'll notice the intensity in his face and the way he wrestles in the ring.
Very, very intense. You watch him, you know he means business when he gets in that ring. Squeezing tighter and tighter as Glover down. Now he has him up. Still has that headlock. All right, they go in the ropes. Catches him right between the eyes.
That backhand has certainly put a lot of men down.
Here he goes. Snapmare takes over. Drops down again. Just. He wants. See what's getting him so mad right now, Tony? He wants this guy to fight. He wants him to fight. And he won't fight him. That makes him even madder. You can just see it.
Oh. No, look at him.
Oh, he's just getting madder and madder. He's starting to boil. Look at him. Now he's rubbing his face in. He wants. See, he respects a man that'll fight him. But if you won't fight him, he's gonna destroy you. Squeezing him. Has that arm now. He's just. Driving it in. Putting that knee in. You know, when you're hot, you're hot.
Now, right now, I think Glover would rather be where he is right now, because when Fernandez gets you up. Glover! Watch here, David. How many times have we seen him pull a man up just to knock him down with a backhand again?
That's what he's going to do. He wants Glover to fight.
Okay. There it is.
That's why he wants him to fight, so he can hit him back.
That one went right to the midsection.
No, he's mad. He's mad.
Right there, we saw that kick, and that shows you that he's well-schooled in martial arts also.
Here he goes, across.
The backhand again. That forearm is really a lethal weapon.
Oh. Knee right into the head. Oh,
Picks him up.
Come on, tough guys.
See? He wants him to fight.
Now he's pulling.
He wants Glover to fight.
He pulled him up
if
that
Glover's
time, David.
He's not going to fight him. He's going to destroy this poor guy. He's got to fight him.
Switched him that time. Oh, there it is. That flying burrito. Got him down, and the man is out. The Raging Bull. Look at him. There really is no need to introduce this man, Ron Garvin. You hear the fans behind Ron Garvin, a man who held that national heavyweight title for a long time. It's now around the waist of Nature Boy Buddy Landell.
Well, that's what's on my mind. You know, first of all, I like to say hello to all the wrestling fans. You know, I've been touring. I've been all over the United States, even the fans up in Canada, up in Quebec. But back to the national title. You know, I was at one time the national champion. Twice I held that title. Now, at Starrcade, I've seen a lot of titles change hands. The national title was one of them. And I've got a lot of fan mail that people are saying, what's happening with you, Ronnie Garvin? How come you don't have a belt? How come you're not wrestling for any title? Well, sometimes, you know, things come to a standstill in your life. Well, that's what happened to me in the last few months. But 1986 is right around the corner, and Buddy Landell, I want to say something. You might not see 1986 as the national champion, because I'm after you. You know, I understand that J.J. Dillon said they had an open contract.
Right.
Well, J.J. Dillon, Buddy Landell, you will find my name on that contract. And I can stay out of here and talk about it all day long, but the place to prove it is right in that square circle. When that bell rings, that's when I'm ready. Now, I'm not a great talker. There's nothing fancy about Ronnie Garvin, but when I step in that ring, I become very fancy because I've got ability and I know how to beat a man. Now, after the 20-minute mark, that's when I get in high gear, Buddy Landell, so I hope you're ready. Because when I step in the ring against you anywhere in this country, it doesn't matter. Ronnie Garvin's going to be ready. And like I said, 1986 is around the corner, and what you got around your waist, I'm going to have it.
Okay, Ron Garvin, thank you very much. Let's go to the ring.
In the ring, the Barbarian is going to take on Alan Martin.
Okay, Paul Jones with the claim that he had the strongest man in wrestling and that he was going to go through wrestlers right and left.
And he has been.
Okay, you're right. But Paul Jones, and we saw the interview, David, with Paul Jones. You know, a little bit more irate than usual. Wouldn't you think?
Yeah, well, he's very confident now. He's put the Barbarian up against several men, and he's done what he said he would do.
Oh, my goodness. There's a show of strength right there.
Listen to him. Animal. Barbarian.
David, I've always wondered, let's say, for anybody wrestling the Barbarian, if you had him, how could you tell? I mean, I've never seen his face with anything but a blank expression. How would you know if you had him hurt? How would you know if you had the advantage on the Barbarian just by looking at him?
If at the end of the match you came out alive, you would know.
Maybe
you had
so.
Him. Oh, me! Oh! Alan Martin, I'm glad it's you.
We talked about intensity earlier, and we're taking a look at Paul Jones' intensity being brought forth in his man in the ring, the Barbarian.
If you could see Paul Jones' face, it's like somebody gave him a birthday present. Oh, he's happy. Look at the Barbarian. Picks Martin up. Just like he was a feather. Slams him on the mat. Oh, what a massive man the Barbarian is. Here they go. Across into the run. Drop kick by a man that's close to 400 pounds, if I remember correctly.
You think about that now. And that is solid.
Oh, me!
Over 300 pounds, and he got way off the mat that time with a drop kick.
Now Jones goes over.
Get in the ring! Set an example for the rest of the wrestlers! One,
big man.
Get out of the ring!
Well, Paul Jones prodding the man around.
Bite his nose off.
Right on the bridge of the nose. Oh, Martin just fell limp to the floor that time. As Tommy Young talks over. Paul Jones, once again, talking about the power of the Barbarian, trying to make an example out of the young man on the ring, or actually down off of the ring. Now look at Paul Jones. Oh, look at that. As you could hear, Alan Martin hit hard on the concrete floor. He hits again.
Get up and take it like a man, or I'll whip you.
Now look at Joe. Martin slowly trying to get up, David. The power slam.
He's up on that top rope. Head first. For the pin. Your winner, the Barbarian.
Okay, now Paul Jones says he has the strongest man in wrestling. There's a couple of men who can lay claim to that,
hey,
but I know.
Tony Schiavone, Paul Jones, you shut your mouth. You can't put up, shut up. Remember, you got one Barbarian. There's two warriors, and nobody beats us. Now collapse. My voice a little scratchy. My manager's been laid up for a while. But we're not done with you. We're going to keep going and going till we get you. And what you did to my brother Hawk, we'll let him tell how he feels about that.
Hey, Koloffs, you like sneak up behind us, throwing a chain around my neck, hanging me over the ropes? Well, you got a problem, because I'm still here. I'm still here. He's still here. And my manager, Paul Ellering's still here. And I'll tell you something. We've looked for 3 years to find somebody that could stand up to us in the ring. You've been the first. But we're still one up on you. Because you see, we're a little different. We ain't exactly right up here. You are. That's your problem. Let's get out of here, animal. Tell him, Paul.
Tony, it must always be remembered, as George Orwell said, all animals are created equal. Some are just a little more equal than others. Now, Russians, think about that for a little while, because you're a great team. I'm not going to take that away from you. And there's a lot of people out there, and you put it on the line. They're wondering in their own minds if the Legion of Doom is all that they've been in the past. Well, we have that to prove to all the people who have stood behind us through all the thick and thin, that Russians, you're going to be the one that's going to go down.
That's the Legion of Doom with Precious Paul Ellering, and we're coming right back.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Ron Garvin against Al Scott.
Ronnie Garvin, oh, you heard him talk earlier about Buddy Landell, that national heavyweight title. One thing you got to say, Ron Garvin's a fine athlete, but so is Buddy Landell.
Yeah, but look at Garvin. Watch him now.
Well, Garvin has the years behind him, has the experience that Landell doesn't have.
Oh.
And he has that big right hand.
He has the temper, the knowledge, the power, the brute force. Look at him. He's got him exactly where he wants him. Scott trying to get out of it. But Garvin,
well,
just overpowers him.
He really is. And oh my goodness. Trying to get out of that headlock that time. using up an awful lot of energy.
I think he's doing this. Oh, here's another man that if you're not going to fight him, he's going to beat all over you.
Ronnie Garvin that time just took his head, kind of moved it to the side.
Oh, look at this. Look at this, Tony.
Maybe that won't work on the old neck muscles, chest muscles, even shoulder.
How do you think you feel the next day? Or even afterwards?
Wearing his man down. So when he uses that big right hand, the man won't get up. And now the fans are encouraging Ron Garvin on.
The man with a fist of stone.
But, and you know, I've said this before, even though we talk about his fists and hands of stone, I hope we're not, you know, selling the man short of what else he can do, because we can
he
see
can
right
wrestle.
Here, he can wrestle.
Well, he sure can.
And even though he has that great knockout punch, former boxer, he's just a great wrestler.
Yeah, good amateur. Irvin, has he? Knocks him across the ring. Hey, Landell, I hope you're watching this. Boy, I hope you're watching this.
Well, if you're Landell, you got to say, I've got to get on the offensive against Garvin. I've got to take charge.
I want you fans to use your imagination right now. Look at the guy in there, Al Scott, his buddy Landell.
Oh. Belly to back suplex.
Oh! What did Landell have to say about this? That guy saw it coming.
He really did.
Cringed.
Winded. No way he could move out of the way that time. And he still had the ability to put the foot up.
Garvin said, hey, I'm not finished with you yet.
All that pressure now right on the small of the back.
Hey, welcome to the big time.
This is what you call getting your opponent in big trouble.
Big trouble. This guy's in definite big trouble.
Look at that move. This is showing the whole wrestling world, especially Buddy Landell,
yes,
how it should be done, how it can be done.
Again, I just want you to picture that guy, Al Scott, as Buddy Landell. And just think about it. Oh, yes. Hard one right in the chest. Takes him now. Whips him across.
Oh, I think this guy made a mistake. I know he made a mistake. He's down and out.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have witnessed a clinic by Ron Garvin.
Yes, you have.
I know I speak for all the fans when I say it's really good to see the Rocky Roll Express with the gold again, the NWA World Tag Team Champions. But, Robert, we were talking earlier, a lot of great tag teams around here now.
Well, you ain't kidding. It seems like all the tag teams are coming out. You got the Road Warriors. You got the Midnight Express. You got the Russians who are hot on our trail because we did win the World Tag Team belts from the Russians. Let me tell you something, Russians. Long, hard fought battle to get these belts. My neck's still a little bit sore. It's going to be a fight from now on, Tony.
That's right, Tony. You know, it's a pleasure to come out here and see all these nice people hollering rock and roll, brother, because one thing is for sure, rock and roll is here to stay. But like Robert was saying, when you are the NWA World Tag Team Champions, they start coming out from everywhere. Like Paul Jones out here talking about his dream, brother. Well, it will be a dream when you beat the Rock and Roll Express for these titles right here, Paul Jones. And then you see the Andersons. They come out here running their mouths saying what they're going to do. But one thing that I don't like, it's when a man comes out here saying what all he's going to do and how he's going to do it, and which his mouth has wrote him a check that I don't think his boy is going to be able to cash. And I'm talking about Jimmy Cornette and the Midnight Express. Now, let me tell you one thing, Jimmy Cornette, and you listen real good, because I know you're out there somewhere watching, brother. There's only one express around here, and it's the Rock and Roll Express. So you come on. You bring your boys on down and show us what you're made out of.
because, brother, you take your best shot. And don't you boy it, because rock and roll is here to stay. And we will see you, Jimmy Cornette. We'll see you in the ring, because we know sooner or later we're going to meet you guys. So you come on, stick your nose in that ring too, brother, because we got something waiting on you. Woo! It's like that old-time rock and roll. No other kind of music can beat it. And it's like the Rock and Roll Express. Woo! The Midnight Express can't beat it. All right!
The World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, once again with the gold in wrestling as the Tag Team Champions of the World. Don't forget to watch us tomorrow night at 7:05 for the best of World Championship Wrestling, and we'll see you next week.